So Avengers Endgame totally bombed at the box office. Totally. In all actuality, you can see how the Marvel Cinematic Universe is a huge success. It is the second most grossing movie in history. Some may see this as a masterpiece, and others will not see it as such, but will still enjoy it. Before I start the review, you need to know that there are traces of spoilers in here. So if you haven't seen Endgame yet, watch it in its entirety.
I'm watching you.
Seriously.
Overall, the movie is very fast-paced, something that may seem unusual for a movie with a 3-hour runtime. The humor is actually funny and not just a failed attempt to try and make people laugh. The next thing might be a problem for some, but the fan service I felt was awesome. It was a perfect flashback to see what happened after the events of previous movies, while having the heroes question their morals and reflecting. I also loved the moment with Cap using Mjolnir and Thor's reaction. The entire third act was perfect with all the heroes returning from the snap and fighting Thanos' army. I found Hawkeye's story to be heartbreaking. His introduction to the movie was perfect. This area of the editorial will be heading in a direction that may cause many of you to shake your heads. Something that I found confusing was how Tony Stark snapped his fingers. He isn't in pain before the snap, yet the Hulk was in pain before the snap. A small gripe that I had was with Thor. In this movie, he has a beer belly and is an alcoholic. That part I don't have a problem with. It's the part where Thor's hyperventilation is played for laughs. Another small gripe that I have is the tone. For a movie that had half of the universe snapped out of existence, this movie has a load of funny scenes. It's probably due to how super serious Infinity War is, but I feel like it could have been more serious, but with some funny moments. Another small thing was with Hulk. It could just be the Uncanny Valley, which is basically, you know something's off, but it looks so real. We know that Mark Ruffalo doesn't look like that, but it looks so real. I feel like there isn't that much that can be done about that. One last thing, please avoid videos about theories for specific movies, especially before it arrives in theaters. It's okay to have your own ideas and think about what will happen, but just enjoy the movie the way it is. Go in blind. These types of movies are not meant to have levels of themes. There are certain movies made for that reason, to make you think. For movies like The Avengers, Avengers Age of Ultron, Avengers Infinity War, and Avengers Endgame, they don't work like that. This is Joseph Zyla from CTTV.